Welcome to Excel English Academy, and today we will read the fourth chapter of standard 9. Book is Movement. Okay, and the name of this chapter is In the Kingdom of Fools. Okay, it is a Kannada folktale. It means it is not written by someone, but it is assumed. It is a folktale. Okay. Now, before the actual start of the chapter, let us recap the word stock of this chapter. Okay? See, groceries. Groceries means eatables. It means you may call vegetables, grains. That is called grocery. Dudu. Dudu, in this chapter it is used and it symbolizes a coin. Accused. The guilty persons who have committed the mistake. Inherited. Inherited means got. What we got from our father, mom, dad when he left the world and he left the wealth for me, that is called inherited. Panicked. Panic means terrified. Means khofza. Sorrow. Solemn means serious, holy. Pursued means make them agree. Okay. Besides these words, there is number of word meaning in this chapter that is very, very important. You should go through the word by word reading and find out the difficult one. Okay. Now, let us start the chapter. In the kingdom of fools. It is believed that people are so dangerous that only very wise people can change, manage them. It means if you are wise and if you are living among the fools, then you are only able to handle the situations. Otherwise, it would be very, very difficult for the common person. Okay, it means if we are wise and have intelligence, we can adjust, we can manage any situations. Okay, who are the fools in this story and what happens to them? Let us read. First of all, now we have already read about this. This story, I have heard it, the story in many chapters. Now, I would like to recap the short of this, a short summary of this chapter, so that you could understand very well. Okay, before let us read the only introduction. In the kingdom of fools, both the kings and the minister were idiots. It means both were nonsense, have no sense. They didn't want to run things like other kingdoms, other kings, so they decided to change the night into day and day into night. Okay? They ordered that everyone should be aware at night till their fields and run their business only after dark and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with the death. The people did as they were told. For fear of death, the king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. One day a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. No one about. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening, when suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. It means it is the kingdom of fools, and that's why everything happens in opposite manner. Okay, the people were allowed to sleep during day and work during night. This was the first strange things. And one day, when the disciple and his guru arrived in the kingdom, they saw that the kingdom is very beautiful and nothing is being seen. Only even the cattle, the animals were taught to sleep during the day and wake up during night. And after, when the gurus and his disciples saw, after becoming dark, people were going to their business, they understood that it is a kingdom of fools. And it was at the peak when they learned that here everything is sold at the same price. At that time, the guru understood that it is surely a kingdom of fool. But this system fascinated the chela, disciple. You may call everything takke se bhaji, takke se khaja. It means everything have same price. Whatever you want, you can take at the same rate. Even you want to take the delicious food, it will be available at the same rate. If you want to take the worst food, that will cost the same. Okay. Now, the guru said, it is not wise to live in a kingdom of fools because we don't know what they will do the next. Okay. This was the word told by guru to the disciple before leaving the city. And the disciple enjoy eating everything at the low price. Okay. So now the guru left and the disciple left there and become fat after eating number of things at the same price. Okay. Now one day a thief was dead. Thief was dead. It means dead due to falling off a wall. And the thief's brother went before the king and asked for the justice. The king said the justice would prevail. It means justice would be done. Be sure. Okay. And then the king ordered his men to bring the house owner who have made such big wall. And that's why he trapped in it and died. Now the owner was before the king and the king said, you are the culprit because you have murdered the thief. Okay. Now the house owner said, sir, I am not the accused. I have made all things right, but it is the duty of wall maker to make it perfectly strongly. But the way the king's order is made to bring the wall maker is before the king, and the wall maker said, sir, it is not my fault. It is the fault of brick maker. It means each maker. Okay. It is not my mistake. The brick maker was brought before the king, and the brick maker said, sir, it is not my fault. It is the fault of the little girl who distracted me while I was making them. Now the king called that girl, young girl, a jingling of anklets disturbed the brick maker. Now the young girls were asked. The young girl was asked and put before the king. And the king asked, why you have murdered a man? The young girl said, sir, I have not murdered someone. It is the fault of goldsmith. It is the fault of goldsmith. And the goldsmith was called up. And the goldsmith said, sir, it is not my fault. I have not called that girl number of times. I was busy in making the jewelry of a rich man. And that's why I was busy and I was unable to make her anklets, and that's why she is coming up and down again and again. Okay. Now the king found that the goldsmith is the real culprit and asked them. The goldsmith maker said, the rich man were asked. The rich man said, "Sir, it was the fault of my father, not my fault. So how you could punish me?" The king said, "You have inherited everything of your father, and now you will inherit his sins as well as wealth both. That's why you will be punished." And now the punishment was fixed, and the hangsmen were asked to execute the rich man. The rich man was very thin, and the stick, it means phans gala ka wo jo phans lagane wala, it was not fitted to that man, and the king ordered his men to find a such man whom the stick would fit. And the king's man found the disciple, the perfect man to whom the stick would fit. And now the king orders his men to execute the disciple. Now the disciple was in trouble and remembering his guru and remembering his words. But after a long he was praying his in the court of the king. His guru arrived there and saw the situation, understood everything, and went before the his disciple and asked or whispered something in his ears, okay, and said, "Okay, now kings, hang me first, then after my disciple." Both were asking, "No, me, and this was the you may call the turmoiling condition in the king's court, and the king was not able to decide whom we have to hang. Now, curiosity, the king asked his guru, "Why you want to be hanged first? You have not committed the mistake." The guru said, "Come here," and said something in his ears, "That I have known that who will hang first, they will rule this kingdom in the next life, and that's why I want to be executed." The king said, "Ooh." He didn't want to lose his kingdom. That's why he thought for a while and ordered his man, "Let postpone the execution program, and we will decide who will be hanged tomorrow." Okay, and the program was cancelled. And after a long discussions, the king arrived at the situation that I should hang myself first, so that I would be the king of this kingdom in the next life. And with his all ministers, they were ready to be hanged and hanged next day. Okay, now the guru and disciple were leaving the city without informing the citizens. Okay, it means common people. And the common people thought that who will rule us. So they urged, they requested the guru and disciple to rule the kingdom. After a long thought, the guru and disciple were ready to rule them and said everything would be as usual and a normal way as it happens in other states. And this way this chapter ends. And what we have learned, that is the moral of the story. We have learned that it is very dangerous to live in a place where the uneducated peoples, fool peoples, live there. But we could handle the situation if we have little brain. Okay, so don't regret where you are living. You must apply your mind to the situations and handle the situations. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the things clearly. Thank you. Take care and don't forget to subscribe my channel.